This video is sponsored by EnvatoElements. YouTube Shorts and vertical video in general were huge in 2022. And in my opinion, they are here to stay and they just get even bigger in 2023. Especially with the new monetization update on YouTube Shorts going live on February 1st, this is a massive opportunity for us creators. Most shorts that are getting millions of views are barely edited, just to put them out as fast as possible. And here's how you can get an edge over other creators. I'll show you a way to create high quality vertical videos that require barely any editing as well and still look professional, so you can put them out as fast as possible and potentially earn millions of views. Now, first of all, we navigate to the website of EnvatoElements. And if you use the link in the description, you will also get a 7-day free trial so you can follow along with this video. Then we want to go ahead to the top, select video templates, then go down and click DaVinci Resolve. Then in this search bar, we want to type in vertical video. And now with your free trial, you can simply go ahead and download the vertical video template that you like. And let's just say it's this one right here. Click the download button, then add it to a recent project or create a new project. In this case, I'm going to select this one, add and download. And after your download is finished, you will get a .zip file. Just quickly extract the zip file and you will end up with a folder similar to one of these. Now, if you open the folder up, you will get a .dra folder. And this folder is pretty important because it houses the whole DaVinci Resolve project. And to open this project up, you can either open DaVinci Resolve in the project library, right click and select restore project archive, and then just navigate to the downloaded folder and just click the downloaded folder and hit open. Or what you could do is just click, drag and drop the DRA folder into your project library in DaVinci Resolve, and this will copy the project over. And once the project has successfully loaded, we can just double click to open this project. And right away we can see a couple of bins in our media pool. And 5 different vertical video templates on our timeline. And to showcase how easy it is to customize them, I'm gonna use the story or vertical video template number 4. And in order to customize this template, I'm gonna go to placeholders in my media pool, open the dropdown right here, and right now we can see images. This is where you replace all of the images. So click on story number 4, and there you got 3 different placeholders, and each of them is in a different timeline. So I'm just gonna double click each one to open them up. And on top of your timeline, you can now see that I've opened all of the different timelines for the placeholders. But if you can see your timelines right here, what you can do is go to timeline view options, this icon right here, and select stack timelines. This will either close or open up the stack timelines, and you can quickly switch between different timelines. So I'm gonna go to the first image right here. Then I'm gonna go to my media pool, right click, import media. And there I just wanna quickly grab 3 images. Now I'm gonna click the first one, drag it on top of the solid color and make it the exact same length. And right away I can see that this image is not shot in vertical mode. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this, go to the top right of my screen to where it says inspector, and then I'm gonna use the zoom and position tools to quickly reframe my shot. Then I'm gonna hop into the next timeline. Then I'm gonna take the next image and basically repeat all of the steps. I make it the same length. Then I'm gonna zoom in and I'm gonna quickly reframe. Then I'm gonna hop into the last timeline, timeline number 4. Gonna open this image right here. Gonna make this a little bit longer. And again, just quickly reframe this. And in order to change my text, I'm gonna go to my media pool once again. I'm gonna go to placeholders, text, then story number 4. And then here, the first one, this says checkout. And I want this to say maybe the name of the boxing company. And then I'm gonna go to the next one, which says clean. And this should say boxing. Let's just make this smaller. Then I'm gonna go to the next one, change this one to club, and then I'm gonna go to the main text. We don't need that, so I'm just gonna delete that. So then I'm gonna go back to my main timeline right here, but we have to change the color from this button right here. And in order to do that, I'm just gonna open this up in its own timeline, open in timeline, and then there under the fusion composition, I'm gonna right click and choose open infusion page. And then I'm gonna use the background to change the color. And right here in the inspector, I'm gonna set that to a white, and the right color from the gradient, I'm gonna set that to a dark gray or black, something like that. And I'm gonna go back. And this is just how simple it is to create professionally looking vertical videos in DaVinci Resolve using templates from EnvatoElements. So once again, big thanks to Envato for sponsoring this video. And if you haven't already, be sure to check the link in the description to get your 7-day free trial and see what you come up with. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and I hope you're having a great day. See you next time. Bye.